Hi and welcome to Cookmas. Vegan piece of cheesecake, executors, French vanilla. Sweet and delicious. This wasn't recording. I felt like the audio wasn't really good with the camera. I mean, I have a mic on the camera, but I think this one is a little bit better. So I'm gonna try to use this as much as I can for you to hear me properly. The thing is, I'm in the bedroom, as you can see. First of all, I wanted to say that in this video, I'm gonna be cooking and we're gonna be making something that I'm really excited to make because I've been thinking about it for quite a long time, trying to plan what would work best. And we're basically gonna be making a vegan Biscoff cheesecake. Well, it's actually vegan and gluten-free. So if you wanna go straight to the cooking part, if you haven't noticed in all my videos now, if you go down here on the timeline where you have like the bar, you can see that it's cut into pieces because it tells you what's happening through the whole video. So if you wanna go see the recipe, skip to that part, find the cheesecake part and just go there. And if you wanna know more about what's going on and hear me talking, stay with me because there's gonna be a lot of talking today. Basically, I'm gonna be wrapping some presents. Actually, I'm not always wearing this t-shirt, although it could be, but the thing is I washed it and everything, but it's just perfect for Christmas and it's been some days since I filmed the last vlog. On the last vlog we went into the city center to find presents and that was a complete failure because we didn't find anything and we got stressed. But today we went again and I'm gonna tell you why, but the thing is that we went into Tiger and we finally got presents. It's really small details, but it's still something. We basically split when we got in. Each one of us had maximum of £10 to spend on small things that the other one could like. I'm sorry because I'm not gonna be able to show them to you because Martin's gonna see the video and the presents are for him. But on the 24th when we open the presents, I'm basically gonna film that so you can see what we got to each other because I'm actually pretty like excited to see what he got. We'll see what he got and what I got and if we got the same things because it was obviously the same shot, but we'll see. We'll see and you'll see too. For the house, this I can show you. I bought these two things because they are super useful. I love them, I use them a lot and I broke the one that I had and it's actually the perfect size for my hand mixer to do smoothies and sauces and things like that, so it's perfect. And I also got this because if you have seen other videos, you might know that I always mess it up when I need to rinse milk things on my drinks and things like that, so I basically got that. So, Christmas. It's been a long day today. It's like 6 in the afternoon when I'm starting this video. And basically we had to go to London today to return the keys of our apartment because in case you're here and you haven't seen the other videos, we just moved from London to Birmingham and you have a vlog of the moving process, so I'm gonna link it. So yeah, we had to go today to London to return the keys, so we had to wake up really early to call the agency, try to ask not to go because if you don't know, London just went into tier 4 because there's a new strain of the virus and everything is pretty collapse. So we had to wake up early, call them to cancel that, and then we had to go to the post office to send the keys instead. Look at this paper, isn't this the cute? Oh fuck, light move. Isn't this the cutest? Yeah, we basically went to the post office and we also wanted to send some things to our families. We just wanted to send some Christmas card that we made and also add there some English tea, and that's basically what we had to offer. And once we got there, we were really literally about to pay. And she was like, no, I can't accept that. Nothing's getting delivered. Like, nothing's going out of the UK, basically. So yeah, we couldn't get that done. And now we have Christmas teas and English breakfast teas. And also we have something that I don't think it's gonna last until we're able to send it, because I bought some French vanilla coffee for my sister in Tim Hortons and I'm actually really excited to try that, although it's not dairy free. So I'm sorry, we're gonna be cheating, I think, because I actually really wanna try it. Maybe then I'm not gonna like it, but I remember it being super good, so I just wanna try it. Sorry Paula, but I think we're gonna be opening this tonight. I mean, you can see, but I'm here doing my duties. The other thing is that my parents actually sent me a box, hopefully of food, and they sent that last week and it was supposed to arrive today. And then we got a message that it was delivered without being delivered, and I don't know, just my grandma also put some things in and I'm really excited to see what it is. There's also a present from my aunt and I'm really excited, and it's not coming and it should have been here, and I just hope that it's already in the UK because with the whole things getting collapsed, I'm basically just a little bit worried about it. So we've been trying to solve that for the past hour and nothing came out of it, so I'm just expecting it to get delivered anytime. And then we have the cooking part. So basically we're gonna be making Christmas dinners ourselves for the first time. We're actually gonna go shopping tomorrow morning for the last things we need for the Christmas dinner. We have decided we're gonna be making a Danish Christmas dinner on the 24th night. Obviously night, because it's a dinner. And then on the 25th, we're gonna be making a Catalan Christmas lunch. That's the plan. And we're gonna go grocery shopping tomorrow for the last things that we need. We're gonna be making cannellones, which is basically cannelloni, I think it's called in English. But yeah, we're gonna make my grandma's recipe. Well, we're gonna try to attempt to do my grandma's recipe. And then on the 24th, we're gonna be cooking the Danish meal. So I'm also gonna be filming that. Seriously, this paper is just so damn cute. We got them! So I'm basically gonna put everything in a bag so he can't see anything. So let's go make the cheesecake I was telling you about. We're back in the kitchen, and before we start with the cheesecake, I'm gonna make some French vanilla. How did you make this? Do you mix it with milk or with water? Enjoy your drink. Okay, so it's made all with water. Let's try it. Oh my god, it's not so good. Here's the teas we bought to send to our family. A mango one. Christmas, which looked so good. But the thing is, we got some samples too. And I'm actually kind of excited. I wanna try this one. That's a pretty huge bag for tea. Mango and bergamot. Oh no, there's mango involved, so that has to be good. Earl Grey, Chelsea Garden, which I have no idea how this is supposed to taste like. So one, two. I'm gonna add a tiny bit first to mix. That tastes so good. I'm actually thinking of making a coffee, an espresso, and adding it here, because this doesn't taste like coffee, but it's absolutely incredibly vanilla-like and sweet. Look at my glasses. So here's my espresso. I think this is gonna taste really good. This is boiling and I can't have my coffee boiling. I need to wait a little bit. Update is my favorite one from the ones I got. It's not amazing to me. I don't like it with coffee still, but for other things, I like it a lot. So yeah, that's my favorite one. And I'm probably gonna make some rice pudding. I'm pretty sure it's called in English. In Catalan, it's arroz amb llet. So I'm probably gonna be making that with the other almond milk I have, because I wanna use it, as I don't wanna throw it or let it go bad. I'm so stupid. Let's move to the cheesecake. So I want to tell you a little bit what I've been thinking and what I want to try. I just want you to know the options and what I had in mind. So we're gonna be using these speculoos. That's the normal biscuit ones, and these ones are already vegan, so if you're just vegan you can use these ones. So I found these ones, which is kind of the substitute, and these ones are vegan and gluten-free, so that's the ones I'm gonna use today. So that's gonna be the base, and we're also gonna be making the biscuit spread with this, because we want it gluten-free, so we're gonna make our own. And then I'm gonna use some olive spread for the cookie on the bottom. So that's gonna be one. And then for the cheesecake, I'm gonna try to make it mixing tofu and this BioLife cheese. If I was making a normal cheesecake, I would probably mix cream cheese like Philadelphia, that it's salty, with a mascarpone cheese, which is like plain. And then instead of sugar, we might use some dates, or we might add some sugar depending how salty it is, we're gonna see. And then also, if it's too dry, I'm gonna add some oatly cream, any dairy-free cream would do. I'm basically gonna be doing that, and I'm gonna film with my other camera because I also wanna post it on Instagram, because honestly, I'm not sure if people watch more YouTube or Instagram. I don't know what's better. Seriously, I can't talk today. Help. I'm basically a YouTube person. I love Instagram and I love posting photos, but I feel like for this kind of content, YouTube is better. That's also why I'm experimenting with the whole blog situation, because I feel like that's something I really want to watch. And if it's mixed with the cooking, even better. This is my absolutely favorite cup, mug, however they're called. I got it on Disneyland, and they have a lot of other movies with this format, and I need to get more because I use it like, I love it. It's so cool. And I always write all my recipes. All my videos have previously been written down because that's how I like to check my recipes. And if I don't have it written down, I just check my phone and look for my post with the recipe when I want to remember. I'm talking a lot today. I'm sorry. It's going to be a talking block. So I think I'm going to soak some dates to make the blend. And I'm actually need to find a place to put you. I want to film this for Instagram too, so I placed my other camera here onto Amazon boxes, my paper recipe here. And as always, remember that all the ingredients for this recipe are going to be in the description of the video, as well as if there's like a post on my website, it's also going to be linked, everything's going to be there. Okay, I have my dates soaking here. First of all, spread. So for this spread, we're gonna use, I added 1 teaspoon of lemon, because I think that's to preserve the spread better. I'm gonna add some dates in. This is too good. Wow, I kept blending it and the color is exactly almost the same. This looks exactly the same. I'm amazed. So we wanna scrape everything because we don't wanna miss a thing. I'm truly impressed. This is looking really good. This is literally exactly what I was looking for. So good. I'm gonna do the rest in here because obviously we don't wanna clean this. We want these ingredients. We want all of it because it's delicious. So let's add more cookies and more butter, and that's gonna be the spread. We just want cookies and a little bit of butter. Needs to go on the bottom. So with this recipe, I'm not trying to make it healthy because I know it's not gonna be healthy, but I'm trying to not add more shitty ingredients to it because we know that the cookies already have sugar. We know that it's not the best. So instead of adding more sugar, I added more dates, but I also know that I'm using a lot of butter. So it's vegan butter, but it's still not amazing. I'm basically making a huge cake just for the photo because it's only two of us here and we're gonna need to eat the whole thing ourselves. So I might try to freeze it. Did the same with my birthday cake. I can't stop eating, it's just so good. And this goes to the fridge. And in the same pot again, because obviously we don't want to clean it, we want the cookie. I'm gonna blend here the tofu with the dates, because the tofu, I would honestly use silken tofu, but I didn't find one, and the one I got is hard, like firm tofu. So I want to blend it and make it as smooth as possible. So let's open this tofu. Actually, I never use this one because I think it's more expensive. I use this one here, I'm gonna link it down because it's cheaper, you can find it easily, and yeah, I just like it more for desserts even more. But yeah, that's the one I got today. Okay, so I basically added the tofu with a little bit of milk because it wasn't blending, and now I'm adding some of the cream cheese. I'm also gonna add some dates. I've decided I'm gonna use Oatly because I know that's better, more creamier, so fajitem.
I hope I've been showing everything. I'm gonna let it rest in the fridge now until it gets more solid, and if it doesn't, I'm just gonna freeze it and have a cold cheesecake. That's fine too. The cheese, I thought this would be too salty, and it's not. You can honestly use that for cheesecake and desserts. It seems salty, but once you have the contrast with some sweetness, it's just amazing. So I'm gonna totally use this again. When it comes to the tofu, I'm never using this tofu again. I mean, if you're vegan, it's super good because it really has some taste. But for baking, you need things that are more plain, so that was kind of an error. But it was still good because when I mix it with all the ingredients, it was nice. I would not use it for dessert, so I would actually use the ones I usually use, basically. So again, they're gonna be linked in the description, and I usually find them easily, just this time it was impossible. I don't know why, there were no fucking tofus in Birmingham. But yeah, and I had to save, I only used half of it, I saved the other half because it was too strong. But yeah, I'll see you when the cheesecake is ready.
Before we keep cooking, we're gonna open the advent calendar.
I think we opened 21 yesterday.
Video game.
Yes, we're playing Overcooked! Yay! We can make more vanilla, French vanilla, and play Overcooked. You want me to play Cyberpunk? He's like, no. I don't think that would be a good idea. Let's check on this beauty. It's pretty good. I just took it out and it looks really consistent, so we'll see once we take it out of the mold. And then basically I heat it up this for like 20 seconds just for the butter to melt a little bit, and I think that's gonna make it easier to spread it on top. Let's do that. Moment of truth.
This is so good. I actually want you to try it.
Nice.
I mean, it's sweet, but
this cake is amazing. You're gonna have a video, the video I filmed with the other camera that you saw. You're gonna have that on Instagram. And if you stayed at the beginning of the video, you already know what's gonna come, what's gonna happen, and what you're gonna be able to see. So remember to subscribe if you don't wanna miss this cookmas, and to like this video because that really helps the channel. And with that said, I'll see you tomorrow. That sounds so weird, tomorrow, you know?
Oh my God. I'm impressed at myself.